Well, guys, it's Phalanges coming at you with another gameplay critique. This one is for Matt Elven King. So Elven King has been with Matt since I think about February of this year, 2017. He sent me this, or actually, no, earlier than that, shoot, I don't even remember when he joined. Well, he sent me this clip a long time ago, and it took me a while to get around to doing his gameplay critique. So here it is. He's playing on the PC. You guys can see here, we're actually in a pickup game, so I'm partnered with him. I'm not Phalanges right here. So this is actually a recent gameplay. This was uploaded April 23rd. So let's go ahead and see what he's doing. So he's running Survivalist, Jetpack, Bowcaster. Little thing, I would've used my Jetpack right there, but I guess you're okay. Just because you stick around close enough to the, you stick around close enough to me to get the partner.
There's one going cave side. Watch cave side, please.
So that's good that you're watching cave side. Personally, see, now you got yourself in a bad situation here, and I wouldn't be surprised if you went down. This is kind of what I was talking about earlier in one of Fupa's gameplays. You're surprising yourself with the enemies. Whenever you go into a battle, you want to have an advantage. You did have an advantage here because you're jetpacking, you have a bowcaster, but what if he's smart enough to pop shield? What if he's smart enough to roll at the correct time? Then you're actually giving yourself a disadvantage here. So
cave
probably
side.
A better...
Watch cave side, please.
A better move would have been right here. Wait behind that rock. Peek behind.
Cave side. Watch cave side, please.
Peek behind this rock right here. Don't jump over. Peek behind this rock. They still don't know that you're here if you were to have stayed behind that rock. So let the one guy come in, let's say, and you kill him with whatever your blaster is. I forgot what blaster you're running. Kill him with the blaster. Then his partner's like, oh fuck. Then you use the jump pack bowcaster on his partner, and now you've successfully taken down both of them. Let's go ahead and... I haven't seen this clip before, so let's go ahead and see how it plays out. I would have stayed undercover there. Yeah, you pretty much just get lucky that he wasn't playing that well there, but right here after you get this kill, you stayed here. You should have done mirror movement. As you guys see, he's going to roll left, which he shouldn't have done. You should have just continued moving right and done mirror movement. Right here, though, I like this. I like this. You went right behind that rock here. If you guys watch how fluid this is... You can tell it's a natural instinct. He moves rocks right there. He stays behind rock. You do come out. You do have your C switch on the wrong side, but you're fine. You got it.
They spawned in tunnel left side.
So now it's good that you're converging on the objective. It's good that you're giving some supporting fire up there. Yep.
One more.
Okay. Now, right now, you should be eliminate him, and then get the partner spawn for me. And that should, even though you guys had we had to do a flip, that's okay. I was able to get back in. Yeah, that's okay. So right here, you pretty much just want to stay behind cover, watch radar, so that they're not spawning behind you. Good job, you did watch radar. Right now, okay, I would try to position high ground. Perfect, just what I was thinking. Unfortunately, yeah, that happens, but,
Can you get a spawn?
And then, yeah, see, I think I had rushed them here because I had lit both of them or something. Oh, oops. A little bit sloppy there, but that's okay. I think I'd pushed him there because I had, like, lit both of them or something. Yeah, we were just kind of pincered right there in bad positioning. I guess if you wanted a tip for this part here, so after this part right here, you and me are kind of in the same spot. And you drop down to the low ground here. Yeah, no, I guess you didn't really have much of a choice because once you drop down, you're pretty much toast because that guy is still behind you. I don't know why Cuddy pulse cannoned you, though. He could have killed you with his blaster, but whatever. So, even though you didn't get this... Even though I didn't give you the spawn, that's okay. You got a good close spawn. Now, just don't surprise yourself. Just...
Where's Cuddy?
This is good. This is good kind of waiting movement that I'm seeing here. Good roll to cover. And yeah, we're not going to get that pod, but it's okay. Personally, that would have been the last person that I would have wanted to do the jump caster on. It's kind of like when you were pulse cannoning me in one of the pugs a few days ago. You were focusing me with the pulse cannon. Same idea with the bowcaster. Right here, you have some tall guy who's got himself in a corner. He's not much of a threat. We need jetpack over. How about, you know, Snake, the one who killed me in midair? You know, he should be your higher priority. Plus, I'm also noticing with your bowcaster, you're relying a little bit too much on keyboard aim. If you guys watch here, he doesn't really move his mouse. He kind of lets the trajectory of his jetpack aim for him. And that kind of leads you to missing. Because see, if you guys watch, right at the tail end of the jetpack, see if I can get this. Right there, he moves his mouse, but again, you're letting your momentum carry yourself forward. If anything, you should be releasing the... It'd be better to even release the shot early rather than late. And then earlier, I saw that same thing where you did that bowcaster and you accidentally hit...
Rats, I missed.
Yeah, right...
Oh, behind us!
Oh. I just missed it. There we go. Right there, where you bowcaster this, it's again because I think you're relying a little bit too much on keyboard aim.
You're packing it on the pod.
Yeah, there's not enough mouse movement.
Oh,
I don't know. It just looked kind of mechanical, is all.
Where did he come from?
Not fluid. So let's go back to where we were. Yeah.
I'm probably wasting too much time trying to get pods this game, too. That's what I was doing last game.
So now this is going to be a tough one. We're going to want to get there first, and unfortunately, we don't.
Man, can't push up.
So, right there, personally, what I would have done is if I'm covering this shit with pulse cannon, you should probably be moving right side here, because then any enemies that come through, I'm going to have your back here. See, by you and I being in the same spot here, we're not really accomplishing anything together. I mean, I should have communicated that to you, that you should go forward, but also you should try to identify when you have an opportunity. Like, now you're kind of trying to push.
I have a Viper probe droid
on it. We're kind of stuck here, too. This is kind of a tough spot.
Should we go through the tunnels and try to flank
Yeah,
them,
so there's one down, so I think now I push here just because there's one down. So that's good, jetpacking. Again, not enough mouse movement. As you guys saw here, like, he's going to anticipate these rolls, Alvin. He looks at you right here. He's looking at you. And yeah, you have your reticle on him. But just know that he's going to roll. Wait for the roll to happen. And if it doesn't happen, then just let yourself be 5 feet in front of him before you fire it. You know, just anticipate that movement. You're playing against high caliber players.
I'm going to try not to run.
So this was good. This was good. You drew their fire here, and I stayed behind that rock. Unfortunately, I finally did go down. But you did draw their fire for a little bit. Honestly, what happened here was we didn't have our teammates to follow up. I don't know where they were. You and I were in the cave for quite a while. They really should have been going through outside. But they had gone through cave again. Again, I wouldn't be going through cave. You should have probably stuck with me. Because this is a choke. And see, yeah, you're already getting lit up.
We're supposed to go through. I'm going to pressure.
You should be shooting that guy behind pod. Again, sloppy mechanical movement. Like, your thought process is way too... I don't want to say obvious. It's way too straightforward here. You're like, shit, I have my bowcaster out. I need to use it. You don't need to. Right here, Elvin, look at this. You didn't need to jetpack at these guys. You didn't even need to bowcaster them. You stay here and shoot them. This is the kind of shit that we don't do right in Pugs, is I'm drawing 1, 2, 3 people's attention right now. You should be capitalizing on that, and that doesn't mean... That doesn't mean, you know, I have a bowcaster, I have to use it. No. Just shoot them.
Here.
Like, right there. Oh, 4 of them focused on me. Their entire team was focused on me. So, all you had to do is probably kill the Imperial officer first with whatever your blaster is. And then, you know, then these guys would be facing you. But this guy right here, he wouldn't have any cover to go to, so you could just blaster him. Best case scenario is this guy who is over here. He would be like, oh shit, Elvin's coming in caves. He's going to look this way. I'm going to see that he's looking away from me, and I'm going to push him, even though I'm low health. Doesn't matter. But yeah, that was just kind of a... That was... In all honesty, we may have been able to hold... Like, best case scenario, we probably could have gotten
people
that.
Just shield to win a fight.
Another pod is down. So right here, you should have stopped. You made a few mistakes here. So you know where they are. I don't really know why you're running along left side here, because if you guys watch, he goes left side here. I think that's to get the charge, which is fine, but look at the red, it's right in front of you. You should have stopped sprinting right here, and you should have peeled off of that, the pickup, and you probably should have, or if you're going to go for the pickup, immediately go ATST. You should know that they're there. You need to be ready for this shit. See, now... Luckily, he was focusing on me, so he didn't pulse cannon you, but he very easily could have. Make a decision fast. Don't fire that. There you go. That was a little bit too hasty, too. Again, I think you're trying to leverage your star cards too much. Remember, the game fundamentally, you can do fine with just a blaster and a jetpack. You don't need a lot of fancy stuff. Also, that red that you were watching, he was coming back here. So just be aware. Right now, I wouldn't be focusing this guy. I'd be focusing up because this guy's off the objective. I got snake down. That means that two maximum are on the pod currently. If you jetpack and take out one. Yep. Okay. I personally would have shot him first.
One coming on pod.
I also would have maintained your position behind pod, as you saw there. And this is more team dynamic stuff that really needs to become second nature for a lot of the people who pug. Once he goes down and you cap this shit, our team is coming from your back right here. If you had stayed here, you would have been drawing their fire fine. Even if you had gone down, you would have been drawing their fire. By moving this way, though, you're moving in the line of fire of us, which just makes it easier for them to defend.
One coming on pod.
Oh, all four of them are there.
So yeah, I knew that you went down, so I gave you a spawn. I'm back off. Also, I don't know why, like, 90% of the time when I do get a partner spawn, I still have to wait around for it. For whatever reason, when I play with Chris, I don't have that problem. But, like, as you guys saw there, he was able to, like, as soon as he is at the respawn screen, he hits the button immediately. I don't really understand why. I don't know if there's, like, a mechanic that people aren't sure of, but I don't know.
Then back off.
So right here, if I were you, I would have communicated. I don't even think I was aware if you were running bowcaster this game or not, but you probably should have been like, for taking out these guys back here, you should have just been like, yo, phalanges, I'm just going to spam jetpack bowcaster in. Give me a bunch of spawns. And I would have been like, hey, okay, perfect. Works well for both of our current card setups and play styles. So right now, I would have... So instead of peeling off of your cover here, see, you make a great push forward. You're pushed forward, and then you decide to move backward. I don't know why. Right now, you should be looking upward. Just stay behind this guy, this thing. Don't focus on these guys. Now kill that guy who's above you. Instead, you do this backwards jetpack, which I don't really... I don't know. I went in because... I don't know. Probably because I saw an opportunity, but like right there, you should have been shooting Snake Shield too, not the droid, just to get his attention. Because if you see here, so one guy's down, I'm in there. They are focused as fuck on me. This means you guys need to push forward, not shooting that droid. That's not the biggest priority. See right now, come on. That should have been a team clear. That he's gonna get a partner spawn now. This is a little bit disappointing to see, because we should really be right now. You're not really capitalizing on a whole lot.
I got the Viper probe droid off.
Right now, I'm drawing two people off the pod. They're two strongest players. If you guys look at Snake's health bar, he has like 10 health. You don't even need to bowcaster him. Save your bowcaster. Kill him with the blaster. And then jetpack after this guy.
Claiming.
See, you guys gotta get a lick there, because they just get a partner spawn.
Yeah, and see, I was pissed there, because he just got a partner spawn after I'd done all that work to push in. And that was a bad move. I don't know, this is just like a public match move. Like, what you did here...
They just get a partner spawn.
You jetpack straight at him, and you press the S key while jetpacking, so that slows down your forward movement, but it also slows down your vertical movement, so you basically just hover in the air. Luckily, these guys are bad players. These are the two weakest links on their team. If that was me down there, you would have been dead before you shot that off. Sloppy movement. And I mean, think of, like, what's your goal here? If your goal is to kill one person and die, then first, like... You accomplished your goal, yeah, but that's not really much of a goal. He's going to get the partner spawn or something, and you didn't really do anything. The smarter move would have been use your blaster. Just turn around. You saw them coming on radar. Don't jetpack. Just go here, turn around, put fire on them. Make them delay them.
Yeah. Behind us.
shields low.
So right there, you're kind of confused as to what to do. This is just an aim confidence thing right here. You're kind of confused what to do, and you go back and forth. Make up your mind and commit to it. And then right here, I don't know what this look down was right here.
Shields low.
But watch this, you guys. When he looks down, he's going to look down to the ground, like right about here. That very may well have cost you the ability to kill this guy. When this guy jetpacks over, you should have killed him. You should hear that jetpack. You should be aiming up. I don't know what this look down was. But you see that? Then you had to move up and you had to start trying to track and yeah.
We're coming.
The Imperial stormtroopers are about to secure that escape pod.
Okay, that's one guy down. This is good that you're flanking here.
Oh, crap. One on the left. Sneaks on the left.
Okay, I would communicate to your team here that you're ready to go in. Go for the higher priority target, not the... See that? Use your blaster, man. Look at how they are so freaking focused on, like, me and the other people. Should have just backed off there. I mean, they're so focused here, and we're just not capitalizing on the mistakes that they're making. Like, you very well there, Elvin, you could have killed three people. Yeah, let me just go over this again. So when you go in here, you're blindly, like, okay, you see them. Don't jetpack! Just shoot him! Just shoot him with your blaster! And so you do jetpack, and look at that! He doesn't even try to counter you, but he does successfully. And that's because, look at that, I killed Snek, and I had two guys. This guy jetpacked at me, and the other guy jetpacked at me. So you get the cap, which is good, and you hear the voices coming from over here. So right here... That noob, whoever's that white trooper, just go back. You don't have... There's no point in trying to defend a pod that we have a sliver of blue on. Just let him reset it. Who cares? Look, this guy's now facing pod. This guy's now facing pod. I'm going to move forward. If you had simply stayed alive and just stayed back... Because you're not going to win this melee fight. If you had just stayed back, we probably... Yeah, we would have been a little bit better off. And see, now they've reconvened on pod, and now this guy gets jetpack again, and he goes after me again. And so I might get lit, and so I'm not able to get your partner spawn immediately. Okay, I guess we did end up clearing that, because we had somebody coming from behind.
I'm here.
I'm watching ET.
Okay, all four of us are here.
Okay. So decide what you're doing right now. Okay, if you're moving forward... See, I don't know... What are you positioning right now? If a guy pops up here with a pulse cannon, what do you do? Okay, you would have died by then. You know, decide what you're doing.
Okay, all four of us...
Like, this kind of... You're kind of like, shit, what do I do? If you don't know what to do, get behind cover at least. Like, this isn't very effective. You can't... If you can't jump up here, you know... I don't know, this is just, like, awkward, like... You're kind of asking to die here until you know, move forward, get to cover, thank you. And also, if you're gonna go help me, like, help me 2v1 this, think of it like Overwatch, you know? Like, I don't know if you're like, oh shoot, I don't want to kill Steel Phalanges, who cares? Think of it like Overwatch, be like, you know, you see some McCree trying to go after a Genji or something, you know, you could be like, oh, it doesn't matter, he'll just flash the Genji and take care of him. Not necessarily. If you're there, help them win. Make it a 2v1. Make it hard for the enemy. Sure, go for it. You know, just go. I mean, all you had to do there, Elvin, was when I start shooting here, just go right here. And that way, I'm covering if he rolls right, you're covering if he rolls left. He has nowhere to go, he'll pop shield, he'll retreat, we'll get the pod. And I do see that you do want to watch back here, but, like, that's, I don't know, just, if you're just playing against higher caliber people, the way that you're using the jump jetpack, you should really only use that to, like, you don't, and also, you don't have to jetpack every single time you use it. You can get on the high ground and use it kind of like a rocket launcher. You know, like, right here, you know, you didn't have to jetpack. You could have just stayed right here, waited for him to land, and I don't know, I guess you're also evading his, that thing, but... Didn't need to roll there. Roll to evade. Don't make rolling. See if you guys watch here. He rolls like. Look, this stormtrooper shooting at this guy. But you still, like, he was looking this way when you rolled. You don't have, just, yeah. When you roll, you're making the aiming harder for yourself. Just roll when you need to. Like, right there, you didn't need to. Imperials are taking that escape pod. We need to stop them. Okay, so they're coming from left and right, but we shouldn't be focusing guys left. We should only be focusing right.
I'm gonna spawn.
Again, you're not really considering, what if that guy had jumped up on Walker? What are you doing? Where's your cover?
Yeah, you're playing a little bit too much chicken there.
Yeah, like right here. You know, all you had to do here to counter this is you're just like standing in the middle here. You're like, oh shit, what do I do? What do I do? You're not giving yourself an exit. Either, like I said, make a decision. Back up or go forward. If you're going to go forward, go to X-Wing so you have cover. If you're going to go back up and see. Now he knows that you're like retreating. If you had been here back here earlier, the fight would have been in your advantage. What happens here is you see him jetpacking at you. Right here, you see him jetpacking at you. He has the drop on you because you've made yourself the prey, basically. And so your decision is to roll away. And, like, good job. He's defending the pod. He didn't even, like, fire a single shot at you, and he's pushing you off the objective. All you had to do here is, when I said I need to spawn, just back up and go this way, and that would have covered you from any potential threats this way, and that would have allowed you to tilt peek this. And then when he jetpacks up here, he doesn't see you. And so maybe he's dumb and he walks over across X-Wing and you kill him. Seriously, could have been that simple. And then see, now you should be tilt peeking here. Again, you let yourself get surprised here.
Yeah, you're playing.
See, you're letting him make, you're like letting him kind of dictate the battle here. I mean, you land a headshot, which is fine. But also look at where your reticle is and where he is. Yeah, you just got pretty lucky with, like, that switch here.
Can't spawn on you. When you back off like that and you don't watch the corner... See, when...
I said this in the game. Yeah, you had backed off and you weren't watching the corner. You just backed off. Yeah, don't just back off. Watch the corner. Keep your eyes open. You know, I don't know what, like, a sports equivalent of that would be, you know? That's like, you know... I don't know. It's just... Just keep your eyes open. Keep your head up when you're expecting somebody.
Too much chicken there, Elton. I can't spawn on you. When you back off like that and you don't...
One other thing here is if you tilt peek this, you could have shot him a lot earlier. But look at how close you guys were for that engagement. You could have shot him back here if you were tilt peeking.
When you back off like that and you don't watch the corner... See, when I need a spawn, you don't need...
That was also a wasted jetpack. Just make sure that you make smarter moves when we're in a time crunch situation. They don't even have to be, you know, fast moves. You don't have to worry about speed. Just worry about, you know, what's smart, what's going to get the job done the best. So, like, right here, I would have at least shot somebody. But I guess you're just going to go straight for it. And it's going to work because they don't fucking... They all fucking single me out. Oh my god. This is hard, man. Yeah, that was a kind of a tough one to avoid. He played that well. You had the right idea to back up. And yeah, that was kind of hard to anticipate that he would jetpack over the AT-AT like that. Honestly, that was more of just a good move on his part. That he prevented the partner spawn. See, both of them are ready to do that.
This shit spawn.
If you wanted to kill that guy, you should have jetpacked already. But see, now...
That's one down. Go, 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 big cat.
Shoot him. I don't know... You're doing a wet waffle here where you just kind of hope that your teammate covers you. Like when you're sprinting in here... Oh, shit. When you're sprinting in here, shoot. Walk forward and just shoot. He's standing in the same spot. You could have killed him. Yeah, you definitely could have killed him. I mean, you got the cat, which is close.
No! I pressed...
But, I don't know, just...
No!
Yeah... Like, I know it was close, but you can still walk forward and shoot. You know, it's like that, there's like that one dumbass commercial where it was like, oh, no, it was from the Sweet Life of Zack and Cody, where London Tipton, she was like the dumb kind of personality in that show, and she would, And like one of the characters like, London, I bet you can't multitask at all. I bet you can't even like walk and chew gum at the same time. And she's like, yes, I can. And she like takes 5 steps, chew, 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 5 steps, chew, chew, chew. She couldn't do both at the same time. Same thing right here, man. Just shoot him and walk forward.
So right here with you.
Yeah.
You guys good, Dukuki? Location of another
pod. Let's capture it. I got the cap. The rope behind that cargo crate.
So right here, when I was calling out cargo crate, you could have done a bowcaster shot without jetpacking. You could have just stayed high ground, got on top of the X-Wing here, and done a bowcaster shot. You may have not killed anyone because of the range, but I'm just saying that's like a possibility.
Alright. I have an R5.
So this is good. 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 You're watching the backside. One little tip here. This is also something that we're seeing here, guys. He's not exposing himself, because something that these guys will do is if you don't expose yourself, these guys will assume it's clear, and they'll put themselves right here for an easy kill. And right now, I'm seeing you're equipping the bowcast. You better not jump pack. You better just sit, wait, and get the kill, and stay there. Defense. We're not on offense. You don't need to jetpack. Yeah, but see, guys, if he had exposed himself, then they would have backed off, and they would have come up with some sort of alternative, like jetpack shield in, or something to counter an easy kill. So just don't jetpack. No! You deserve that. You 100% deserve that. Oh my god.
Oh wait, one's...
That was more sloppy movement. That was just kind of like, kind of messing up, like you're using a controller there. I was saying that this was just kind of clunky, like you meleeed the air here, and I don't know, it was just kind of like you're playing with your left hand, you know?
Oh wait, one's...
Like you spawn it in first person, which means you're holding C, or whatever your C switch button is, and right here, you rolled at him. He was moving left and you rolled at him. That's the equivalent of like, if somebody's jetpacking the air and you fire a rocket at where they were, you know, you're not going to hit him. You're going at where he was. And because of that, you know, you've done these like weird melees.
Got sneak.
Let's just see this again.
Oh, wait, one's...
Like, make up a... Like, you did two like midair melees, which was just weird. What would have been the smarter move would have been... You have 3 teammates meleeing that guy. He's fine, because I get the first melee right there. Just turn around. Like, look, you don't melee this guy. Get pod, turn around, shoot him. Oh, it's just weird, clunky movie. You should be watching Red. Red should be going low right now.
Oh, shit.
Like, see, I said, oh, shit, but that's because I knew that they were coming that way, because I checked this side.
Oh, nice headshot.
You should probably, we have 2 people down, you should really be turning around and helping out Pod.
We're really helping Pod.
Help Pod. Thank you. That was dumb. I don't know why you just did that. Wasting all the cookies, I get the strategy behind it, but doing that, burning an imploder, I understand burning the blaster cannon, but burning the imploder, that was a bad move. I mean, if anything, you get the imploder here, you see that I'm fighting 2 guys? I don't know, throw the imploder where the red guy is. Like, don't just burn it. I don't just have thoughts behind your actions. Don't just do it because it's what you always do, you know?
Okay,
so now you need to decide if you're going to get here first. I would have your blaster up. See, the fact that you run around with Bowcaster, that you're using it like a primary, really goes to show one of the weakest parts of your gameplay, and that's not universality of using all your cards. You know, one of your main weapon is your blaster. That should be the number one thing that you get kills with. Not your bowcaster. If you're getting most of your kills with the bowcaster, then one of 2 things is happening. You're not playing well, or the other team's really bad. Actually, no, if the other team was really bad, you'd still be able to get blaster kills. Yeah, pretty much that. So, let's continue on here. So right here, do not jetpack at them, you're gonna die. Yep. Wouldn't have mattered. Seriously, if you got in the air, do you think the outcome would have been any different?
His shield's low. Oh, nice shot.
Crap. That was a good roll to cover here.
I'm getting lit.
And you guys see what I'm doing here? We have one... we have one, two, three teammates in this trench here. And who's the one who's not bunching up with everyone else, who is one imploder away from dying?
I'm getting lit.
It's just, you know, being back here, you're not leveraging anything. The only shots that you're putting down range are ones that I could equally as well accomplish. If you're going to help, go this side so that this sucker in the corner here can't get that as easily. Or jetpack in so that he can't get a partner spawn. Just don't. Okay, here comes the jetpack. Too late. See, I did it because I was preventing the partner spawn, but your thought too slow. He would have gotten the partner spawn by then. So again, you're not. I mean, I guess you're fine right now. But it's just like, what are you watching? You're just watching me for when I go down. You know, just what's going through your head here? Why is your position this right here? You know that. So with me being here, we know that they spawned back cargo back here. So that means they're gonna come through here, or they're gonna come through tunnel. I don't see anyone going right here, and Phalanges is covering that. So you should really be looking right now. Should really be looking right. You have a jetpack and a bowcaster. Again, too slow. If you had jetpacked up there earlier, you'd be in a power position. You could literally just sit there, crouch, don't expose yourself, charge your bowcaster, wait for the noob to go right here and kill him.
One's coming.
Instead, you plant a droid and you let them move forward. Luckily, you know, I was watching that shit. I hit him, too.
One's coming.
I think he only got one hit on him. Right?
Yeah.
Yeah, you hit him once. Yeah, okay. So, I would have killed him, too. Like your shot, you got a kill, but it wasn't anything to help the team in particular.
Yeah, Cuddy came behind.
Also, you rolled in the wrong direction there, so now we should... Oh, wrong move. See, you're gonna go down.
Partner spawn.
You got really lucky there. I understand you're trying to get away from the melee-er, but this is the last pod. We have this here. It's worth dying to get a hit on. Because there's no way that he could possibly recap it. But like this right here, now you're charging your bowcaster on the same ground as him.
He's gonna get a partner spawn.
If I wasn't, or if whoever was shooting him, somebody was shooting him and made him pop shield. If that other person wasn't shooting him, you would have died. So. Oh well. It's at least good that you pushed him there to push him off, but. Yeah, okay, so that was me shooting him. And then the R5 droid also by somebody.
That was pretty damn good.
Okay, good. You didn't blow all the star cards here. So now you really need to be... Don't dick around. Really need to be hauling ass right here. We need to get inside first. That's what this is all about. I wouldn't even be going that way. Why are you going around when... Make up your mind! Oh my god, Elvin! See, this is the kind of stuff that I'm talking about. You need to make up your mind, because here you go back and forth. Okay, let's think about this. If you're going to go back here, what's the advantage? We've already capped it. So what's the advantage of going behind? You get to give Phalanges a spawn if he goes down. Okay. What's the advantage of going forward? You get to push with Phalanges. You know that they're spawning over there. So you're going to be able to support you and the two other teammates who are over there. You don't need to go in cave right now. If you had sprinted this way from earlier and... You had done that bowcaster. If you'd done a jump bowcaster such that you would land with your jetpack about here. Look, I'm shooting somebody. They're probably low. There's probably more than one if I went down. That was wasted. Told you. This was a Russian. And look at that. It's like you're playing with the controller. Look at how he turns in midair. It is so like unidirectional. Just like not like you like it's just he turns in the air. So yeah, we need to be hauling ass to get in there.
That
And see right here again. Why are you walking around the corner when there's enemies and shit? Rats. You like walk around the corner, and if you are gonna walk around the corner, tilt people. Look at this. You're not even able to see them until you're exposed. Look at this. You're exposed as well. If you had gone right here and tilt peeked, you could have. But like, I was drawing fire. There's no reason for you to like just walk around. I mean, I got like it's fine. But there you go. Shoot shield. Okay, jetpack left. Doug's good. That was again kind of sloppy movement. You know, you should be. Okay, think about this. You're using a projectile-based weapon. That means you need to shoot where they are going, not where they are at. When you jetpack in, where are these guys going? They're going to the pod. Okay, aim at the pod. See? He does a roll, and he dodges it. Because you fire here, you correct here, but it's too late. Aim where they are going, not where they are at. That's like 101.
Okay, I got Cuddy.
Again, yeah, that
good
was...
Point. Thank you. Okay.
Yeah.
Just kind of lucky that... Basically just... You'd played that pretty poorly, because when you jetpack in here...
Pick an air coming.
When you jetpack in here, you know, think about... Where's your cover here when you miss? Oh, look at that. No cover. You get hella lucky that I'm putting pressure on them, too, and that they're both lit. And so, and that they're bunched up. This was a mistake on their part that they had bunched up. And look at, you're rolling to the same, like, plane as me. If you had rolled right here, you would have killed both of them. Or they would have both died, like, instantly. Just because, watch, when I go back.
Doug's lit on.
So, I'm in a shield right now. If you would move this way, they have two options. Get killed by you, because you have the line of sight of them here. Or, option two, they move around here and they get killed by me.
So,
it works out. But you see, he rolls back there to cover, because he knows he can. If you had positioned yourself here all along, better results would have happened. Because then you could have, yeah.
Okay, I got Cuddy.
But it worked out.
Good point. Thank you. Okay.
Yeah, it was... Basically, just the spawn that gave us.
Okay, I'm gonna kind of harass them, and then I'll just spawn a new elven. So just be prepared for me to need a spawn.
Okay, good. Thank you for listening.
Nice.
Kind of sloppy. Again, sloppy movement. It just kind of feels like you're unfamiliar with the game.
We have the location of another. Okay, grab a cookie.
Whoa, you're playing at high sensitivity too. Shouldn't have jetpacked there, because now look, you land, no cover. And you had to pop shield for that. Not worth it. Just be aware of... Yeah, it's just an awareness thing. You're just... I know it's like, yes, I have a jetpack. I use jetpack. But that's not how the thought process should go. I know you're, like, trying to catch up to these guys. But, like, what are you expecting? You jetpack here. You catch up to them. Good job. You've caught up to them. And you land here. And you're at the low ground. And you have three people shooting at you.
Did you see that though? I pulled both of them up.
Again, work on your dexterity a little bit. If it helps, just play public matches and like just practice rolling around. Like this roll right here, you should not have gotten caught on that box.
Did you see that though? I pulled both of them off the pod there. Come on, I mean.
Chow pig.
Don't know why you jetpacked there, because look, now you land. And there's a guy behind you, by the way. Oh, again, he doesn't shoot at you. He kills me. I'm up here. Just look at what you did. Here's this enemy right here. I'm still alive right here. You bowcaster the guy in the shield. You take down his shield. Congrats. That's the same thing that a person with an ion grenade can do. Meanwhile, you use two cards to do that same task of taking down a shield. And you've put yourself in a bad position, and you basically let me go down, because right here you could have killed this guy with a bowcaster. And then look, who's the higher priority? The noob who's probably low health in a shield and definitely not going to get this pod because we have two teammates on it, or the guy who's going to give his partner spawn because he's in like the best power position for assaulting this pod ever? Literally, this crate is what changes the the who gets this pod right here. Like, you killed Doug, but... See, and now you're lit, so I was able to get a spawn on you. Now you should be moving forward. I'm going around left, so you should go around right. Nope, wrong move. What are you going to hit?
Okay, that's okay. He's
back off. Like, what are you going to hit there? Just... You see me going left, just go right. That should be instinct. You know, you want to get kills, just play smart. Right here, you're sitting waiting. What are you watching? Are you watching for me to just die? Because what are you doing? Like, what are you accomplishing? Like okay. If you're sitting here, you're watching two spots. Okay, you're watching if they go left here or if they go right here. Well, guess what? If they go left here, I can see him too. I'm going to kill him. If they go right here, we have two teammates on pod. They can see him. They're going to kill him. Right now, you're positioning yourself on the pod, but you're not doing anything. And there's been a lot of that this match. And then again, they make this mistake of they have one guy right here. I'm pushing left. We have three guys back here. All we need is one jetpack bowcast to go this way, land about here, and you kill this guy. Instead, it's like you kind of do this weird, like, whoops. You kind of do this weird, like, let's stop. Let's, like, abruptly stop. Right here. We abruptly stop, kind of randomly look around, equip, kind of look around, fire an arbitrary shot that doesn't get any hit markers. He gets a partner spawn. You lose health. You lose your positioning. You know, more harm than help right here. Certainly. They're like, again, right here, what are you doing? I see red going towards tunnel. I make the smart move to, they're in tunnel. I'm going to position myself so they can't fucking move out of tunnel. The way that you're positioning yourself, if they are going tunnel and they go here, what do? You back up towards pod? Congratulations, you just let them, like, walk forward towards the pod. I'm just trying to push him off. Okay, right here, good positioning. Okay, this is okay, but you're surprising yourself and you're just gonna die! Have you not been taught enough times this match that they're literally gonna kill you out of the sky? I mean, he just kind of derps out. He finally gets you, but like, oh my god, haven't you been burned enough? Shouldn't you know that this is, like, not a fight that you should... Like, look at this. You do this... Okay.
Careful, Doug has a pulse, this, has a rocket launcher.
The crouch thing that you do here is so weird. Right here.
Could he try to come?
Boop! You can't see him anymore! What? So if one of them equips a smart rocket and is running towards you, you just sit here and like, wait for the jetpack to come in for you to die? Like, keep your head up. You can't... Okay, you tilt peek and you can see this guy. What about the other guy? See, switch and move your camera to the left here so you can see both of them. Instead, you... What's this? You do this jetpack. You miss the bowcaster because you're trying to hit a guy in midair. And then you go down.
Two shields.
Oh, just not accomplishing anything. Oh, it's so cringy. Yeah, and I give you a boss fucking partner spawn because, again, I push... Do you see that? The only two people that the three of you guys needed to take care of were Snek and whoever his partner is. I don't know. They're the two Imperial officers. 3v2. That should be your guys' job. 3v2 on a defense? That was because when I went tunnel here, I took care of half their team. I took care of two of them. Capitalize on that. Push these two suckers. Right here, fire your bowcaster from right here. Wait, right before, okay, before you jetpacked, if you were watching him, you could have killed him right here. It's just like so many missed opportunities because you have to do a jetpack with your bowcaster. Also, another issue that you could have certainly done here, look at where you rolled. You rolled right. Like, again, where are you landing? You land with no cover, and then you roll right to even less cover. We're on defense. All you had to do is roll left and sit there. You don't even have to shoot him. Holy shit, he's on defense. It's like earlier where he pushed you off the pod when you were top of AT-AT, and he literally didn't even have to shoot at you. He just jetpacked up there, and you kind of got caught with your pants down, and you retreated. That's all you have to do for defense. Just roll left. Roll left.
Whoa! I didn't know.
Oh, man.
There were three of them there.
Yeah.
Man, Pig and I always die at the same time.
It's okay. Just... What are you doing here? Where's your cover? Okay, there's your cover, and you're dead. See, this is just kind of a lack of forward thinking when you play. This is just, like, watch. I know you want to go in here, but you know that there's shots coming around. So where are they going to be, Alvin? They're going to be back behind this plateau thing, or they're going to be behind cargo. You roll right here. Where do you go if they're behind plateau? Here, maybe? Where do you go if they're behind cargo? Here, maybe? Are you probably going to die before you can get there? Oh, yeah. And also, you rolled this way, again, to no cover, not, you know, roll towards the cover. You executed that so well earlier with that one rock when you, at the very beginning of the game, you know, do more of that. And, they're going to push me because, you know, it's like a two-on-one situation here. So, again, yeah, you get the partner spawn, but... I wish I could know what your score is right
okay,
now.
Okay, they got the long spawns. So
you definitely have the potential to be like second place. Nice. What are you doing? What are you doing? Okay, you got to teabag him. Okay, cool.
I'm just staying
near. Again, what are you doing right now? Are you playing pod defense? Because if you're playing pod defense, then all you're doing is you're going to jetpack over this thing and drop his shield. Okay. Again, somebody with an iron grenade can do that. Without blowing both of their star cards. You know, what are you doing? Be like phalanges. I'm going to go harass them and their spawn with a jetpack bowcaster. Do that, then. Yeah, that aim is pretty clunky.
I need the spawn.
This is kind of, like, controller.
Nice.
Should have jetpacked earlier. Yeah, just like a bit of, like, waiting. Like, why is there this wait here? You know he's going to land right here. Jetpack now! Kill him as soon as he hits the ground. Instead, nice. You wait for him to hit the ground, and then you go in. Again, it doesn't matter because it's the end of the game, but it's just kind of weird, clunky. Anyway, okay, I'm worked up. Sorry, guys. I'm worked up partially because I, like, partner with Alvin so many times, so it's really weird seeing it played from his perspective, because now that I know how he plays, it's like I'm going to change how I play so that it better favors the both of us. So, yeah. Maybe this is really insightful to you guys, though. Maybe those of you guys who are out there who run Jetpack Bowcaster and you feel like you die a fuck ton, maybe this critique is going to be useful because this shows you a lot of, you know, when you jetpack, look at where you land. Don't just think of it as like, oh, there's one enemy. I'm going to jetpack and bowcaster him and he will die. What if he doesn't die? What if he shields? What if he jetpacks away? What if he has a partner with him? You jetpack in the middle of, you know, bunch of sand, then there's no cover. Yeah. Also, as you guys can see here, the strength of partner spawns and the strength of partner dynamics. Like, there was a lot of opportunities. In the beginning, Alvin had that really good one, killing the people behind the rock. And then also when we were in the cave, Alvin and I had that good little pressure on them. It could have been tweaked a little bit better, but certainly you guys can see how two good partners can definitely take on a team of four people. They just really need to be in sync with each other. Okay, so I guess that does it. Thank you guys very much for watching. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. And I look forward to doing the next critique. Next critique might be Destroyer from Matt. He sent in a clip, so we'll see if I can get that done. As always, guys, thank you very much for watching, and I hope you learned something.